Hi Star Family, my name is Marissa. If you're new to my channel, welcome here. If you've been here before, thank you so much for your support. Today's video, I'm gonna let you guys in on the biggest secret of how to win the game of life. And this is one of those really ballsy claims, right? Because how can you have the answer? How can one person have the answer to how to win the game at life? And I feel like the first thing to understand is that the game of life is a game of perception. And so if you guys think of little kids, so I have a 5-year-old, so I get real-time examples of this. If you think of kids, if you've ever played a game with a kid, like they will make the rules as they go. Right? And they will change the rules in their favor. So for example, one time my daughter and I were playing a game and I had 18 cards and she had 17 cards by the end of it. And usually it's whoever has the most cards wins, right? And so we counted up all our cards by the end of the game. And I was like, I got 18. She was like, I got 17. And I was like, I win. And she was like, no, mom, actually the person with 17 cards wins. And I was like, how funny how that works, right? But kids just offer so many lessons in terms of the game of life, right? And it's just so natural too for us as species to want to cheat or want to bend the rules to work in our favor. It's almost like this innate understanding that we not only deserve to win, but we can actually make it so no matter what's actually happening on the game board, we're actually always ahead. Right? And the ultimate perspective shift to understand in terms of the game of life and how to win is that not only are you playing your part, but at the core of who you are also all the other players. You are also the maker of the game. You're the maker of the manufacturing codes or, you know, the rule book. You're the entire game. You're all the players. You're not just playing your own role, but you're playing all the roles for everyone else. So if you can see from that set of lens of I'm all of it, then there's no potential threat. There's no way that you could even possibly get close to losing. Sure, you might have some detour. Sure, you might get sent to jail and then find yourself happening on a get out of jail free card, but that's all part of it. That's all part of the fun. That's all part of the suspense. We wouldn't be here if we knew how the outcome was going to be or if we knew what was going to happen around each corner, right? That's not the fun of it. But the fun of it is being able to be on this roller coaster ride, to be able to play the parts and to make your move with whatever pieces that you have available to you in that moment and not be attached to what that means. Not making it mean anything about who you are at the core of who you are or where you're going or what you're worthy of attracting in your life, what you're worthy of experiencing, because you understand that it's all here to serve you. It's all here to grow you. It's all here to help you win. Right? Because what makes a good master at anything is someone that's experienced the pitfalls. It's someone that has known the intricacies of how the game works. If you just take people that play video games, like even the short amount of time that I was like consumed in video games, isn't it funny how we all want the cheat codes? Isn't it funny that cheat codes even exist? And so I kind of see cheat codes as being parallel to an awakened being, someone who's awakened, someone who understands spiritual law and operates from spiritual law. Things are going to work a little bit differently. You can call upon the rosebud. What is rosebud? I think it might be Sims, where you can just like manifest as much money as you need, like at any point in time. Like, how do I find that cheat code, first of all? But second of all, I feel like that is such a beautiful example of how innately we feel like it should be that way. It is that way. It's not gonna always be the surplus that we think it should be, but we do have the cheat codes when we understand it's all gonna work out, right? Because anything that you need, anything that you can merge with, the highest timeline that you can merge with starts in this now moment. It starts how you feel now. And you can't expect to tap into those cheat codes to activate that cheat code if you're coming from a place where you don't have access to that code, right? And I know that seems like kind of like a backwards way of looking at it, but you have to be the code before you can expect that code to activate, right? And so in the game of life, if you understand that everything that you meet outside of yourself, it's either here to add to your heart already opening and telling you that you can trust and you can have faith and you're getting confirmations, you're getting synchronicities of this is the way that it works. It's not just all in my head. It's not just wishful thinking, but this is actually the way that it works. It's either that or it's either these obstacles, these challenges, these get sent to jail things, these take four steps back. If we also understand that we design the game in that way that somehow, even if I can't see it in this moment, that this suffering, this anguish, this confusion, this obstacle is somehow going to help me along my way to winning my own game, then it's like, where's the fear? Right? There's only those challenges to break your heart open even more. So it's either your heart's being broken open even more, or your heart is being nourished and confirmed, right? It's all here to serve you. And if you really understand that it's all here to serve you, it's like you're much more likely to take risks. You're much more likely to see it as like, this isn't actual money. These aren't actual numbers in my account, because that's all it is in your bank account. It's just numbers. It's just numbers fluctuating. Basic addition and subtraction. That's it. Right? On a game, when we're playing a game, we're much more likely to take those risks that we know we want to take. Right? And we don't see the failure as being a failure. It's just part of the game, right? And when we win, we're stoked, we're excited. It's like, yes, I took that risk and it worked out. But it's like at the end of the day, we're not attached to it because we know it's a game. Therefore, we're fully in it. Therefore, we can actually play our cards and play the pieces to our fullest ability because we're not afraid of losing because that doesn't exist. We know it doesn't exist. We know it actually means nothing about us when we invest all of our chips into something and we lose them all. It's part of the game. It's only when we get attached to what we think the outcome should be in each moment, forgetting that it's not about getting anywhere, right? You're always winning if you feel a certain way about yourself. And on the same hand, on the same coin, you're always losing if you feel a certain way about yourself. It all comes back to how you feel. That's inner engineering. That's how to win, right? Your game. And it doesn't matter what anyone else is experiencing of you or their idea of what your life should look like or if you're winning or losing. Because a lot of the times those people that are operating from that dualistic perspective of there could be a win or there could be a loss are usually the people that are the most trapped, right? They're the most inside cages because they don't understand they're inside of a cage to begin with. It's all perception. You can always win and you are always winning. When you remember, you're not just playing your part. You're playing all the other roles. You're playing all the other supporting actors. You are the stage. You're the scenery. You're the scene changes. You're the catalyst for the scene to change in a positive way or in a negative way. But understanding it's all there to shape you. It's all there to form you. It is all there to set you free. You're always winning, my friend. Especially if you're watching this video, and my most humble of opinions, you are winning. Keep it up. Keep your head in the game. And remember that it's just a game. All right, Star Family, if this resonated, go ahead and give this a thumbs up. Give it a like. Share it with someone that maybe you were inspired by or you thought of during this transmission. Leave a comment. Connect with your Star Family down below. And we'll connect very soon. Much love.